So what is swaging? And what's the difference between swage and swageless cable systems? Well, today we're gonna find out. My name is Brian Jacobson. I'm the Senior Product Development Manager here at DecksDirect. And let's get to it. Swaged versus swageless. What's the difference? And which one is right for you? Swaging is the process of permanently attaching a fitting to a cable using a hydraulic crimping tool and a matched die set. It creates a strong, secure bond through pressure and friction. It's a more hands-on process, more time, more tools, and slightly more visible hardware, but also lower cost. Swageless systems, on the other hand, are pre-engineered for easy installation. No heavy tools, no crimping. Just assemble and go. It saves time with a cleaner look, though it may cost a bit more. Swaged equals more work, more time, lower cost, and a little bit more visibility. Swageless is less work, less time, higher cost, but also less visible. Again, taking a little closer look at swaged versus swageless systems. In a swaged system, what the installer is having to do is basically what the factory is doing in a swageless system. So at some point in time during manufacturing, this fitting was not swaged onto this piece of cable. Together, they just were a fairly loose fit. Through the process of swaging, this became a permanent fixture on this piece of cable. So how do we do that in the field? Well, one, we start off with our crimping tool, which this is a hydraulic crimping tool. This is a specific unique die set that is sized for this particular fitting piece. And what we do is we basically open the die set so that we can fit the actual cable fitting in there. So in the field, you're gonna wanna feed the cable into the fitting, and then you're gonna wanna feed the fitting into the die set. Turn this knob there, and we're going to, now we've got enough pressure on the tool that's, to hold this fitting in place. So now we just need to physically crimp that fitting. So we're gonna put more pressure, and we're gonna put more pressure. All right, loosen that right there. And you can see that hydraulic crimper has made an impression onto this fitting, right? So it's literally compressed the stainless steel onto this cable, and this thing can no longer come out of there. So that is the process of field swaging or job site swaging of cable fittings to cable. So not a huge deal, but when you consider in Skyline, you have to do this 11 times on each end of the cable run, so that's 22 total swaging operations for every single cable run. You can see where that is gonna add some time to the installation. Conversely, when you take a look at a swageless system, the factory has already put that fitting onto the end of the cable, right? And so with the Skyline Pro swageless fitting kits, the kits come in lengths 5 foot increments between 5 and 50. And additionally, there's 60 and 70 foot cable kits. But this fitting is on the cable. It simply threads onto one end, which is the tensioning end. And you run the cable over to the other end where the cable terminates, and you simply put the streamline rapid lock on there, and that's it. So quite a difference in terms of how we're attaching cable and how we're tensioning cable. You can see that took a few seconds. This one took a little bit of setup, and we're only halfway finished. We still need to put a fitting on the other end and crimp that in place. So, two very different operations, same general outcome. One's just a little faster, a little cleaner, but one will offer you some cost savings. Both systems offer long-lasting performance. The choice depends on your tools, timeline, and taste. Learn more at DecksDirect.com.